Hi there, welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here and we're talking about the exponential function. Right, let's start with something we've already looked at previously. We should know a graph like this, y is equal to x squared. It's a quadratic graph. I want you to compare it to how this one looks, y is 2 to the power of x. Can you just look at two equations and state how they're similar and how they are different? Well, they're both of the form y equals, okay? They both have an x in it, they both have a 2 in it, but the role of the x is very different in each one. Here, the x is the base number, and when we've done index form before, we know what x means is the base number. And all the graphs we've ever done, x has been on the bottom. For example, y is 3x, y is equal to x cubed, that type of thing. Whereas this time, x is what we call the exponent or the power. And these graphs look very different to the ones we've previously looked at. Now, whenever we're looking at a new graph, we always start off by a table of values, plotting out the graph from a table of values and see if we can spot any patterns. So let's go straight in and do that. Complete the following table and plot the graph y is equal to 2 to the power of x. Pause the video and have a go at that. So 2 to the power of negative 5 is 0.03125. This one would have been 0.5. This one would have been 1. Anything to the power of 0 is 1. This is going to be 2. This is going to be 4. And this is going to be 8. So plotting these, we get something like this. And joining the dots as best we can. Okay, and that there is our approximation to the graph y is equal to 2 to the power of x, what we call an exponential graph there. Okay, now how it works is this here is important. This is a horizontal asymptote. Y is 0 is a horizontal asymptote. No matter how big our negative number we put in here, say we put negative a million, y equals 2 to the power of negative a million. It's near 0, but it never quite gets to zero. It always approaches zero from the positive value. We've looked at that before and we've said that as x tends to negative infinity, y tends to zero from above. As x tends to positive infinity, we can see what happens. As x goes off this way, y shoots up even quicker. Y tends to infinity way, way quicker, and it goes off really quickly. And that's called an exponential graph. Now we're also asked to use your graph to estimate the value of y when x is equal to 2.5. So let's give it a go to try and draw the graph x is equal to 2.5. Looks just a little bit over 5. So we can approximate y is just a little bit over 5. Okay, and it also asks us to use your graph to estimate the value of x this time when y is 7. So let's draw the graph y is equal to 7. It will look something like this. And what do we get there? We get an approximate value for x. If we look down here, it looks like it's about 2.9 or something like that. So there we go. We've been able to use our graph to make these approximations. Let's have a go at another graph, this time 2 to the power of negative x. Pause the video and fill in the table of values and then try and draw the graph. Well, 2 to the power of negative negative 3 is going to be 2 to the power of positive 3, which is 8. This one's going to be 4, this one's going to be 2, this one again is going to be 1, this one here is going to be a half, and this one here is going to be a quarter, like that. So if we try to plot these, negative 3 goes up here with 8, something like that. Negative 2 goes with 4, something like that. Negative 1 goes with 2. It also goes through 0, 1 here, and then 1 goes with a half, and 2 goes with a quarter, like that. And we can kind of see what's going on here. It's like 2 to the power of x, apart from it seems to be a reflection in the y-axis. So it's doing exactly a similar thing here. Again, it's got an asymptote, a horizontal asymptote, that is, at the following line, y is equal to 0. And as x tends to positive infinity, y is tending to this asymptote, y is tending to 0 from above. And as x tends to negative infinity, as we go for big x, y is tending to infinity really, really quickly. Let's try and answer these questions as well. It asks us to estimate the value of y when x is negative 2.2. We can try our best to do that here. So let's draw the graph y equals 2.2. Here's 2. There are 5 divisions, so they're going up in 0.2 each time. Very approximately, it's about, you know, 4.6. About y is approximately 4.6. It's only a guess. And we're asked to find the value of x when y is equal to 6. So let's draw the line y is equal to 6 and draw where it crosses about here, and we're looking at something like negative 2.8. So x here is about negative 2.8. There are our guesses, and we're done. Okay, having drawn a few of these from the table, we're getting a flavour of what they look like. Let's use a bit of graphing software to make more generalisations. So here's a piece of graphing software, and say if we just typed in y is equal to some number a to the power of x, like that. And we're going to add a slider, and we're going to make a b 2 to start. You see that? So that's the one we've already drawn, 2 to the power of x. What if we drew 3 to the power of x? Okay, one thing is constant about it. It seems to always be going through x is 0, y is 1. What about 4 to the power of x? You can see what's happening there. What about 8 to the power of x? Okay, it's still asymptoting to y is 0, and it's still shooting off to y is going towards infinity as x is getting big, but even quicker. But it's always going through 0, 1. So look, all it's doing is flattening out there back to the graph we were used to, which is the graph y is 2 to the power of x. Now let me draw another graph, y is equal to a this time to the power of negative x, the second one we drew. And you can see, have a look at that. Can you see that this graph is just a reflection of the other graph in the line x is equal to 0, or the y-axis? So you can see that they're very similar to each other. They have the same shape, other than one's a reflection of the other. So as I move around, they move in a very similar way. You can see that that's y is equal to 2 to the power of x, and y is 2 to the power of negative x this side, y is 2 to the power of positive x that side. Now the last thing I'm going to do, if you don't mind, I'm going to take these away just for now, and I'm going to draw the graph y is equal to 2 to the power of negative x, and we know it looks like that, right? Then I'm going to draw the graph y is a to the power of x, okay, and I'm going to make a be equal to 2, like that, okay? So they're the two graphs we had before. This is y is 2 to the power of x, this is y is 2 to the power of negative x, and we've talked about them being reflections in the y-axis. Now watch me do something pretty cool here. I'm going to make a in this one, I'm going to make this one here be a number less than 1. So watch, I'm going to make it a number less than 1, and watch what starts to happen. It starts to look like the other one. And in fact, if I make it, if I make a to be 0.5, this is true. 0.5 to the power of positive x is the same as 2 to the power of negative x. So that's something I'm just going to finish off with at the end and summarize in the slides at the end. So let's see what we've learned here. The summary is that if I'm talking about a being a number bigger than 1, the graph y equals a to the power of x looks something like that. And it always goes through x is 0, y is 1. That's because anything to the power of 0 gives you 1. So that's what these graphs look like. Now, if we'd still got a bigger than 1 here, then the graph y is equal to a to the power of negative x is a reflection of this one in the y-axis, okay? So for example, this could look like, this could be the graph y is equal to 2 to the power of x, and this graph here would be y is 2 to the power of negative x. There are, one's a reflection of the other in the y-axis. Now there was one little thing at the end we also spotted using the graphing software, and let me try and explain it to you. We realized that y equals 2 to the power of negative x actually turned out to be the same graph as y is equal to 0.5 to the x. I just want to take a second to explain that. So just say I have y is 2 to the negative x here. That is the same thing as y is equal to 2 to the power of negative 1 lots of x, isn't it? Okay? Which is y is equal to 2 to the power, and we can write 2 to the power of negative 1 all to the power of x. because we know by the power of the power rule we can multiply our powers like this, which is of course 2 to the power of negative 1 is 1 over 2 to the power of x, which of course is 0.5 to the power of x. So that's just something to consider. In particular, the other way around, if you saw something like y is equal to 1/3 to the power of x, you could think of it as y is equal to 3 to the power of negative 1 all to the power of x, which is y is 3 to the power of negative x. So it's a really useful fact to just have in your mind that things like this, y is equal to, let's call it in general, some number 1 over n to the power of x, that is actually the same graph as y is equal to n to the power of negative x for any whole number n. And it's a useful fact for you to have in your mind. Anyway, that's it for this particular video. Thanks loads for watching.